Number 9, Tyson Jost.
Arguably, he's the best 15-year-old hockey player ever to lace up skates in the BC Major Midget League. Tyson Jost of the Okanagan Rockets had one of those seasons most kids only dream of. His 44 regular season goals in just 36 games set a new BC MML record. He finished with 88 points to win the league scoring race and helped his team to a 32-win season, scoring 225 goals, both new club records. Pretty impressive in just his first season in the league.
Well, I think the best thing you can say about Tyson is he's a complete player. I know our staff likes to call him a 200-foot player a lot, but it's true. You know, there's not an area of the game where Tyson doesn't work hard, and I think that's what makes him so endearing to scouts and managers is they see that whether he's in the neutral zone, the offensive zone, or the defensive zone, he's working at an absolute high pace to try and achieve some success with what he's trying to accomplish.
He shoots the puck like a pro, even though he's only 15 years old. And when he's on the ice, he's a difference maker every time, whether it's, you know, beating a couple of defensemen and getting to the net, or whether it's in our end, defending our zone and getting the puck out. He can do it all, and he seems to do it all with ease as well.
I always work hard. I try to work 110% all the time. And I mean, I like to contribute offensively, but I try to be the best defensively too and help my team in the defensive zone. But I mean, hardworking for sure, that's what I can describe myself.
It's that hardworking attitude that was even noticeable in Bantam that first caught the eye of Rockets general manager David Michaud. And it didn't take long for the Western Hockey League to take note as well. The Everett Silvertips selecting Tyson 7th overall in the Bantam draft.
We scouted him extensively last year when he was playing Bantam hockey and certainly knew that he was going to be a dominant player. And certainly with his position in the Western Hockey League draft going 7th overall to the Everett Silvertips, I mean, we were fairly confident that Tyson would fit right in with our lineup. So we extended an offer to him. We were in a position where we knew he wasn't going to be able to attend our evaluation camp because he was at a previous commitment with the All-State camp in Toronto. So we were fortunate. I mean, he mulled our offer over with the family and decided to join our hockey club when he came back from All-State and instantly impressed during his exhibition time. And we knew that we had made a good decision.
When we heard there was a chance that he was going to stay and play for this team, it was a quite exciting time around here. And then when he was named player of the weekend at the All-State tournament for the top prospects in the country, he kind of got the commitment from us right away as it was the same weekend as our tryouts. And then once he showed up at exhibition, he was dominant right away, putting goals and assists up in the first couple of weekends and carried it right through until this point.
Tyson just recently turned 16. Despite his age, he is considered a leader on the ice and in the locker room, a role that is just fine with his teammates.
As a teammate, Tyson, he's really good in the room with all the boys. He's a leader. Even being a 15-year-old, he brings a lot of leadership. And everyone looks up to him.
Me and Tyson, we sit beside each other in the room, so pretty tight that way. And also on the road, we stay together, so gotten pretty close that way.
I think when he first got here, he definitely, he'd established himself with his play and his off-ice work ethic. But he wasn't very vocal at that time, and I think now, as the years progressed, he's gotten more vocal and he's definitely become more of an all-around leader, not just by his work ethic off the ice and what he does on the ice, but also his, the way he talks in the dressing room and the respect he has from the guys.
It's tough to be a leader, I think. And it's tough for a 15-year-old to be a leader. I think he did a lot of good things for us on the ice in the early going in the season. I think guys realized that Tyson was a leader, but I think it's his personality. He's a humble young man, and I don't think he wants to force his will on anybody, so to speak. So I think it took some time for him to realize that he was a leader in our group, but once that sort of came to fruition, it's been a big part of who we are.
I'd have to say Sidney Crosby. I mean, he's a world-class player, and it's hard not to model your game after him. He almost doesn't do anything wrong, so I try to model my game after him for sure. I mean, again, he's always working as hard as he can on the ice, no matter what. On and off the ice, he's working as hard as he can, and he just battles all the time, and I mean, I definitely have to model my game after him.
He means an awful lot to us. I consider him to be our heart and soul. Like I say, just his ability to elevate his play when the chips are down. You know, there's been certain games throughout the final little push here for the playoffs, that we've been in some serious trouble, and Tyson Jost has single-handedly, I shouldn't say single-handedly, but he's been the straw that stirs the drink, Ryan. So for us, it's there's no question depth is probably our biggest strength, but it seems that he's the guy that ignites the fire for us and gets everybody else going. And when Tyson starts going, it's infectious, and that's kind of the best part about, I think, his game for us, is that guys will follow his lead.
You know, without him, I don't know if the dressing room's even the same as it is right now. I think he brings a lot of different guys together. So I think, you know, on the ice, what he does is very important to this team, but off the ice is just as important because of his natural ability to keep a team together and just kind of keep the mood light. And when things get tough, he's the first to embrace it and try to be the guy to get the team out of the hole.
As many unbelievable highlight reel goals Tyson has had this season, it's the moments off the ice that make a complete hockey player, but more importantly, makes a 15-year-old 15.
There's a few, but one that sticks out is on the bus. We have rap battles sometime in the back of the bus, and he likes to let loose.
My favorite moment with Tyson would have to be when I bunked with him for a week in Penticton V's main camp. We shared a couple good memories there. Spent a lot of time on the beach and during the summer, and it was a good moment.
From the first time he put on skates at the age of 2, learning the basics from mom and grandpa, Tyson Jost of the Okanagan Rockets has one of the brightest futures in hockey of any local player. He has the respect of his teammates, on and off the ice. The coaching staff and management have been very impressed with how he conducts himself at such a young age. And for Jost himself, with all of his talents, his abilities, his highlight reel goals, he's heavily weighing options for school and education just as much as the next step in his hockey career.
He's willing to learn, he wants to adjust, he wants to change, he wants to become a better player. So he's always asking the right questions, and he always listens and does the right things. He's a very coachable kid, and it's great to have him.
When you're moving the puck up ice and you see Tyson there, you know he's going to do something good with puck. So, yeah, he's a good guy to pass to.